Hello, everybody, and welcome again to another installment of California Saltwater Fishing. We are once again coming out of Dana Wharf Harbor fishing on the Sum Fun. This is at the very beginning of September. This is the second installment of our Dorado special. As you may be well aware, this has been a great summer for Dorado fishing. So we'll start off pretty quick here with the first hookup of the day. Beautiful jump, as you can see. So this was a good fight, and the fish today were a bit finicky. Lots of boat traffic, as I'm sure will be very apparent in many of the shots. So we had to be a little more careful with the lines that we were using. I was starting out with 15-pound test just because it was a little bit more of a picky sort of bite. And that was for better or for worse. In this case, it didn't work out so well for me, but as you can see, it's a pretty good fight up into the bitter end.
Coming down, going over, going under.
So there was about, I believe, 25 folks on the boat. So not crazy crowded, but definitely enough to make it interesting. And on that 15-pound test, you really got to let your drag do a lot of the work for you and try just to tire out the fish as much as possible. There was lots of fish in the water, as I'm sure you'll probably see from some of the footage of the fish just swimming around everywhere and jumping here and there. As you can see, this one's coming closer to the boat with a second one following just behind it. Probably one of the more beautiful fish in the sea. And I got the fish close to the boat. Josh was going to go for the gaff, as you can see right here, trying to get it landed. But once he got the gaff close enough to it and just kind of touched it, the fish took off. So unfortunately, he wasn't able to get the gaff. He's a great deckhand, so it just didn't happen that one time. And I was trying to get the fish back to the boat. And as you may understand, your first hookup of the day, you get very excited and the adrenaline is pumping. So I may have been pulling a little harder on this fish than I probably should have, given the light test. Probably had the drag a little too tight just because I was a little bit too eager. So I guess that's a good lesson there. When you're going on the light tackle with fish like this, it's better just to let them run. And here we go. It's gonna snap here in just a moment. There it goes. Snapped. Done. Expletives are flying the whole bit. Luckily, there was plenty of other fish out there, as they say, in the sea. And I hooked into another one at a next stop that we got to. Look at all the boats out there. As I mentioned, that's what's making you have to use the lighter line and the smaller hooks. In this case, I was using a size 2 Gorilla Light, and that seemed to work pretty well. The bait was kind of big, but it definitely hid well amongst the big bait, and it caused the bait to be able to swim more freely because it wasn't dragging a big hook around. And I was pretty able to get hooked up on the 15-pound, but as I mentioned before, you want to take it easy with that and let the fish do more of the work. So in this case, as you can see, I'm letting the drag out a bit more. In some cases, I'm probably winding down when I shouldn't, but I'm just letting it run, letting it do its thing. In total, I got 4 fish on the boat for that day. And snapped off probably another 4 or 5. So these are just the clips from when I actually remembered to turn on the camera. And this was a pretty good fight overall. Yep, there you can see him jumping. There's lots of fish out there and lots of boats too. But even with all the boat traffic, the fish were still more than happy to tussle it up with you as long as you had the lighter tackle and it wasn't obvious that you're throwing a big rope out at them. And I was nose hooking the bait. I know a lot of guys were doing the butt hook on them, but I don't know, the nose hook was working better for me, especially as I was casting out a bit more to get away from the boat. When I was casting out with the butt hooks, they tended to come out half the time. And when these fish were this voracious, it didn't seem to matter quite as much as long as you had the smaller hook. So because of that nose hooking, you can see my bait getting dragged around by the line, because the line went right through the nostrils out in one side, out the other.
Okay, I'm coming back.
And had my bait dragging around near the surface as a result.
Coming under you. Coming under you. Or over you. Coming down. Coming down.
Go ahead, you're under, you're under.
Coming down.
Some good jumps. These are some fun fish to fight, probably pound for pound, some of the best action you're gonna get, especially once they start jumping out of the water like that. Because this one got a couple of good jumps on me. And yep, you can see some other folks fish jumping out there too on the horizon. So action packed, that's one thing that these Dorado do provide, is some great action. Once they're on a good bite, it's one of the more fun fish that you can tie in with, that's for sure. And this one had me going back and forth across the stern a few times. But like as I said, I wanted to take my time with it, not pull too hard on it, just keep a nice steady level of pressure on it. Let the fish, oh, there he goes running again. Let the fish run, do what it's got to do, get all of its energy out without putting too much strain on that line and that hook. And this one was one of the nicer of the group that I got. But adrenaline was definitely flowing, especially given the snaps that I had previously with some of my other fights. And that was one thing also on the trip too, you were constantly hearing the sounds of anguish as fish were snapping off and breaking off, and you would hear snap, crackle, pop as lines were giving out on folks. But that's light tackle fishing for a fish like this. It's gonna happen. So when you come on these trips, be prepared to bring a bunch of hooks and an assortment of leaders, so that way you're able to take advantage of whatever bite you may have. And this fish definitely gave me a heck of a good fight. And one thing also, it's good to not jerk on the fish. It's not largemouth bass fishing. You don't want to jerk too hard on them when you're setting the hook. And I was talking to some guys who were kind of new to this, and they were saying that they weren't getting any hook sets even though they were feeling the bites, and it's because they were jerking the bait right out of their mouth. That's why when you feel these guys take the hook, you just kind of want to wind down on them and give it a slight pull at the very end just to make sure that the hook is set. If you jerk too hard, there's a good chance you're just going to pull the bait out of their mouth. Let them chew, let them get a good bite. And you know, when you're in free spool, let it run for a little bit and let them really take off with that fish. And it's better that they get the hook a little further in them rather than an inch away from them, and that's no good for anybody. So we'll talk a little bit more about that in the clip that's coming up, because I was able to actually capture one that was on the film that just took the hook. As you can see, this hook is very well set. And this guy is giving me all that he's got.
Come on, Pete. Go get all the way to the corner. Follow him, bud. Sorry, dude. That's my bait.
And this spinning setup did all right for me. I can't complain too much about it. Although I am now looking into getting a spinning setup with a bit more of a heavier drag. because if I was tied into something a little bigger than this, not quite sure if the reel would be able to handle it.
Watch out, coming down.
So this was about the maximum that this setup was capable of handling, but I would like to get a heavier spinning setup, because despite the bad reputation that spinning reels get for some reason, I think that they do serve a good purpose. And oh, here we go with Josh getting the gaff. Got this beauty in. Great deckhand. Working hard that day for sure. And we'll get a quick shot here of the fish on the deck. Beautiful bull. Nice headshot too. So here's another hookup that I had along the rail, still on the 15-pound test again. So as soon as I dropped that guy off, retied my hook, came back out, put on a new bait. And as you can see, the action was pretty solid. And this fish, I started recording a little later. It had actually taken me completely around the boat. So as you can see there, that fellow on the right of me is just casting out, and by the time I come back to him again, he'll be hooked up again. But this fish actually had me running all the way around, a full 360 around the boat. And as you'll see, unfortunately, it doesn't end as well as I would have liked. Yeah, here we are up at the bow, and when you get to the bow with these types of fish or any other sort of fish, you really want to be careful navigating that anchor. Make sure that your line is not running underneath it as best as you can do. And this is why having a slightly longer pole is best, so that you can help navigate the fish around these sorts of obstructions. Because if you bang on to the anchor, or the anchor works as it is, you're gonna lose the fish. That's for darn sure. And yep, here I am taking my Dorado for a walk around the boat, and once again trying not to put too much pressure on the thing, because this 15-pound test, it can take a lot, but if you're both pulling, you and the fish at the same time, there's only so much that stuff can take. And this was even with the fluorocarbon. And I like the fluorocarbon for the leader. I pretty much try to always use it, unless I'm fishing for something like rockfish or things like that that don't quite have the teeth or don't quite have the sensitivity that some of these game fish do. Because of the abrasion resistance, the fluorocarbon can often be your best friend. So here, as you see, coming back up to that spot where we started the video earlier, and that fella's hooked up. But unfortunately, my fish runs across his line and snaps off in the tension. And there it goes. Fight is done. And at that point, I realize, okay, that's it. I've had enough of this 15-pound. Don't want to deal with it. I'm ready to ratchet up a bit and move on to something heavier. So I go ahead and grab my 20-pound setup with the CalStar and the Avid reel. So now we're gonna get serious and tie into something. A slightly bigger hook on this one, but just a size one. So it's a size one Gorilla Light. Definitely love my owner hooks. So picked a good bait, found one that was swimming nicely. Grabbed it, pinned it on by the nose pretty quickly. You definitely don't want to hold on to the bait any longer than you have to. Once it's pinned on, you're good to go. And then just start looking for a good spot to cast out at. Try not to cast out too far and hit one of those boats out there that's right off the stern. So yeah, just find a spot over here off the stern. Cast out just a bit to get away from the boat. Didn't have to go too far away. And as you'll see, rather quickly. As soon as the bait hits the water and starts swimming off and taking some line, there you see some of the line coming up pretty quick. Let the fish take the bait, take the line from you. It's okay. Pulling quickly, wind down, and you are on. See? No big gnarly hook sets, no Bass Pro type of action. Just go ahead and wind down and the hook will set. There goes the fish jumping off in the distance, and we're on. So I have to admit, on this setup, it felt a lot easier, a lot smoother, a lot less of the sit and wait and let the fish run itself out. If I was able to get some line and if I was able to work that drag a little harder, I definitely did. And even though it's only going from 15 to 20 pounds, the difference in how hard you can pull is much, much greater. So I was making the most of it and making the most of the stronger reel with the stronger drag as well too. And then, yep, just kept pulling in as much as I could. And the fish gave some good runs around the stern. And there were fish all in the water. This was an incredible stop. I can see why all those boats were out there, because I wouldn't have been surprised if someone could have just free gaffed a fish down in there. Yep, there goes some more jumping. It's a great fight, great fish. But then I got tangled up with the fella next to me, Sky Roy, who I've ended up fishing with quite a few times. And his Spectra ended up getting tangled up on the tip of mine. At first, I was worried that was my Spectra because they're both blue. But Josh, as I mentioned before, great deckhand. One of the great deckhands on the Some Fun. Jumped right in to take care of that tangle and get us all fixed up. And tangles are going to happen, guys. And Roy's a very experienced fisherman, so he knows what he's doing. But it's going to happen. And Josh advised to just put the line in the free spool, even with the fish on there. It's not going to go anywhere. And luckily with the Spectra, I have some faith that it won't go anywhere, that line will keep intact. And as soon as he got the tangle out, I put it back into gear, started winding down again, and the fish was still on.
We're good.
And we're back.
There you go.
All right. Jump in.
Yeah. Good job.
Good Josh job.
So who knows, maybe letting it run on free spool for a minute helped to get some of the energy out of the thing. And with the hook set well, and with the faith I have in those owner hooks, and the faith I have in the equipment that I'm using, gives you some more confidence that you're definitely going to land this puppy. So here I am heading back up the side of the boat once again. As you can see, people are bringing in fish left and right. So you really want to keep your head on a swivel, be very aware of where the other fish are going, where your fish is going, where the anglers are going, where the choke points are at, where the possibilities of failure may be. And don't be afraid to let these fish run. I saw, there goes a good jump. I saw a lot of fish lost from folks tightening down the drag a little too soon. But let them run, man. That's what we're out here for. You spend all that time trying to get a hookup, you know, fight the fish, let him go where he's going to go. And as you can see by the shaking on that rod, they definitely give it their all. As I mentioned before, pound for pound, one of the best fish you're gonna fight in the sea. So it's starting to gain some more line on the fish. Do some pulls up, some pulls down. The GoPro actually had to stop there for a second and keep recording because I went from one fight to another. It's a long sequence here. but hopefully you guys are enjoying it. And that boat next to us started creeping in even closer. So as I mentioned, lots of boat traffic. But even despite all that, these fish were still staying up and were very hungry and very voracious. But because of all the boat traffic, you definitely had to keep it below 20. After this fish came up, I tried to get onto my heavier setup, my 40 pound, but they just weren't taking. And then the captain said that we actually had to leave, even though we didn't all have limits around the boat. But the Sumfun is not a long range boat. It's not a boat designed to take on a lot of fish. It doesn't have a refrigerated saltwater hold or anything like that. So they were keeping the fish in giant fish bags with ice. So we were running out of room. And to prevent the meat from spoiling on this super hot day, up there goes the gaff. And now Josh was there to help me out on that one too. Fish is on the boat, looking beautiful. And it broke off the line in his mouth. But yep, beautiful fish there. And he takes it over to the bag, drops it in, gets you a good shot of the fish. And as I was saying, we had too many fish on the boat at this point, and the fish bags were getting full. We were running low on ice, and the captain decided it's time to head back. So I'd love to know your thoughts on that topic, you know, if the captain made the right move, if it's better to not sacrifice the fish that we have for the potential of catching some more. I personally went home with 4 fish, which is pretty good. It was a lot of meat. And sometimes, as they say, you know, don't fish for your limits, but limit your fishing. And that's definitely what we did here. But I can say it's hard to leave that many fish in the water behind. But hey, don't want to get greedy. And there's my fish getting filleted up. So you can see some beautiful fillets that came out of these. And me and the neighbors had a great barbecue. So hope you all enjoyed the footage. Thanks again for joining us. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. And please like and share with your friends. And until then, tight lines and best of luck. See you on the water.